Hello, my name is Russell Hoppenstein, and I'm the High Speed Data Converter Application Manager at Texas Instruments. In our RF sampling series, today I'm going to be talking about the RF sampling architecture. This is the traditional super heterodyne receiver, and it's suitable for measuring wide bandwidth signals. Key aspects here is first the mixer that down converts from either your RF band or your microwave band down to a fixed IF frequency. And then the quadrature demodulator, which would down convert from that IF to a fixed baseband. Now here, with the quadrature demodulator, we'll be separating it into the I and Q channels with a dual ADC to capture each one of those channels. And the ADC only needs to support half the bandwidth of the original signal. So it makes the ADC capture a little bit easier in this case for wide bandwidth signals. Key issues here is that we have our first mixer stage that tunes a RF frequency down to a IF band. And the quadrature demodulator that has the IQ pass, we have amplitude and phase balance issues with the quadrature demod that can impact signal integrity. Now let's look at the RF sampling receiver. Here we're going to eliminate the quadrature demodulator and the RF synthesizer and replace it with a single RF sampling ADC that's sampling at a very high frequency, very high sampling rate. This architecture can now support higher signal bandwidths, and we can even directly sample the RF band if that's the operation that we're in. With this architecture, we have simplified the lineup and we've provided ourselves more flexibility. With this architecture, the spectral performance can now support wide bandwidth signals or multimode signals that are separated in frequency space. And this is able to support bandwidths that were not previously obtainable due to the ADC sampling rate limitations with previous devices. We're able to realize size and power dissipation improvements because now we've eliminated the mixer, we've eliminated RF synthesizer, and we've eliminated a lot of the baseband signal conditioning components. We've increased our flexibility as well. We can support those wide bandwidth signals, the multiband applications. We can support a digital predistortion that has an expansion bandwidth that's very large. We can also now support higher density systems, MIMO, beamforming, large antenna arrays, large radar arrays, and we can implement multiple standards or configurations like software-defined radios much more simply as well. Thank you very much. If you have any further questions, you feel free to contact our application experts on e2e.ti.com.